part of x2. Fourier transform of the odd part of xt is same as j times imaginary part of the nth well. To part A. That means whatever L we have determined part A, of that if we take J times the imaginary part, then we get the Fourier transform of odd part of X T. So this we will be using this real only. So imaginary of this becomes sin omega upon j omega square minus e raised power minus j omega by j omega. This is what we get, and its imaginary part becomes minus sin omega by omega square plus cos omega by omega. We can take just imaginary parts. Imaginary parts from this becomes, if I multiply by j, this becomes minus. So this, and if I expand this by Euler's identity, we get just cosine term as imaginary part, sine term giving the real parts. So this completes the problem. Then problem number 4.10. Part A, use table of Fourier transform to help determine the Fourier transform of the following signal. Which is xt t sin t by pi t square. We have to find out the Fourier transform of xt by using Fourier transform table. From Fourier transform table, from Fourier transform table, we know that sin omega t by pi t is Fourier transform. X is given by x j omega, which is 1 0 when mod omega is less than equal to capital omega, and when mod omega is greater than capital omega, then it is 0. If I compare these two expressions, we immediately get that capital omega is 1. So, in this case, what we get is sin t by pi t is Fourier transform becomes x j omega 1 0 mod omega greater than less than 1 and mod omega when greater than 1. This is for the Fourier transform of this. Now, let us construct a signal y t. Let y t be sin t by pi t into sin t by pi t, and try to find out its Fourier transform. Sin pi t by sin t upon pi t upon sin t by pi t. Let us call also, let x 1 t be sin t by pi t, and we know its Fourier transform now is given by x 1 j omega, which is 1 0 in the range mod omega is less than 1, mod omega greater than 1. So, the Fourier transform of y t now will be, say, y j omega. Let us define the Fourier transform of y t by y j omega. Then we get, since we have defined x 1 t, the Fourier transform y j omega will be 1 by 2 pi x 1 j omega convolution x 1 j omega. This is what we will get. Now, this we have to compute. Oh, this will be 1 by 2 pi integral minus integral over say theta, x 1 j theta, x 2 j omega minus theta d theta. We have to compute this convolution relations. Now, x 1 j theta is 1 when mod theta is less than 1. So, what we get is 1 by 2 pi integration over theta, x 1 j theta is 1 when theta varies in the range minus 1 to 1. Then x 1 j omega minus theta is also 1, but when theta varies, omega minus theta varies in this range. So, here since the integration is with respect to theta, we have to find out a common solution to this. Let us take this part first. Shift omega to theta to this side and this to this side. So, theta becomes less than omega plus 1. Now, let us take this part, shift theta to this side, then theta becomes greater than omega minus 1. So, we have got two inequations in theta. One this, another this. We should have a common solution to this. So, we can argue that y j omega y j omega is 1 by 2 pi integral theta, the maximum of these two values, theta greater than equal to maximum of minus 1 omega minus 1, and theta has to be less than 1 and theta has to be less than omega plus 1. So, minimum of 1 and omega plus 1. 1 into 1 is 1, integration over theta. So, we have to find out this integral. Now, let us take the radian frequency x omega. When omega minus 1 becomes minus omega, then this gives omega equal to 0. So, omega equal to 0 is the common boundary. That means there are two regions, one before omega equal to 0, other after omega equal to 0. Before omega equal to 0, we can get when omega plus 1 is greater than minus 1. Every element of this set has to satisfy, has to be greater than or equal to this. So, omega plus 1 has to be greater than minus 1, which gives omega has to be greater than minus 2. So, somewhere minus 2, and now omega plus 1 has to be greater than omega minus 1, which is universal truth. That means it is true for all value of omega. Now, omega has to be greater than, 1 has to be greater than equal to minus 1, which is universal truth. 1 has to be greater than equal to omega minus 1. That means omega minus 1 has to, so omega has to be less than equal to 2. So, other value you get is 2. So, that means there are two regions where y is omega is non-zero. So, this is one range and this is another range where y is omega is not 0. So, consider the range minus 2. Now, in this range, as omega varies in this range, so omega becomes minus 2, this becomes minus 3. So, minus 1 is greater than minus 3, this is maximum. Now, when omega becomes say minus 1, this becomes minus 2, this again remains maximum. When omega becomes 0, both becomes equal. That means minus 1 remains maximum in this range. So, y j omega 1 by 2 pi minus of 1. Now, let us see what about this. As omega varies in this range, omega becomes minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. So, this is minimum, and when omega becomes a minus 1, minus 1 plus 1 is 0, this is minimum. When omega becomes 0, then this becomes. That means the minimum value in this range is omega plus 1, and this is 1 into 1 d theta, omega plus 1 of d theta. If I integrate, then I get 1 by 2 pi integral of d theta is theta minus 1 to omega plus 1, and if I solve, then what we get here is 1 by 2 pi omega plus 1 minus of minus 1, that means 1 by 2 pi omega minus 2. This is in the range from minus omega to omega equal to 0. Now, let us consider the other range. consider the range, range 2, which varies. Now, in this range, let us try to find out what is maximum minimum. Omega is 0, both are equal. If omega becomes 1, this becomes 0. Since this is negative, 0 is maximum. When omega is 2, 2 minus 1. So, this time, now this becomes maximum. So, y j omega for this region becomes 1 by 2 pi omega minus 1. This is maximum value for theta. Now, let us look for the minimum value. When omega is 0, both are equal. When omega is 1, this becomes maximum. So, minimum value becomes 1 and integrate d theta. Now, if I integrate it, then we get y j omega as 1 by 2 pi theta omega minus 1 to 1, this becomes 1 by 2 pi 1 minus omega minus 1. So, that means 2 pi twice omega minus this. Now, we have got two real. This is in the range minus 2 to omega 0 and y j omega equal to this, and this is 1 by 2 pi 2 minus omega in this range. Let us graph it. If we graph it, then say let us, this is omega axis minus 2 to 0 and 0 to 2. Minus 2 to 0, this is 0 at omega equal to say 0, this becomes minus 2. At omega 2, it becomes 0. Okay. At omega equal to 0, this becomes 2 pi minus 2, that means minus 1 by 2 pi. Made a mistake, this will be 2. So, at omega equal to 0, this minus minus become plus, omega plus 1 is 2. So, this is omega plus 2. So, if we sketch this, we get this part. At omega equal to 0, this is 2 by 2 pi, that means 1 by pi. This for y j. And then, when omega becomes 0, rather 2, this becomes 0. So, this goes like this, and at omega equal to 0, we get 2 by plus same value. Now, this is the Fourier transform of Fourier transform of y t, that means y j omega of this sin square t by pi t or sin t pi t square. This is the Fourier transform of this. We have to obtain the Fourier transform of x t, which is t into sin t by pi t whole square. You know that if we multiply any signal in t, then we differentiate the Fourier transform in frequency domain. So, Fourier transform of x t, say x j omega, this will be j times d y by d omega Fourier transform of y j omega. So this becomes j times d by d omega Fourier transform of y j omega is 2, 1 by 2 pi omega plus 2 plus 1 by 2 pi 2 minus omega in different ranges. So this becomes j by 2 pi in the range minus 2 to omega 0 and minus j by 2 pi in the range, this is your x j omega. And if you graph then for this part, this is x j omega, this remains constant from minus 2 to 0. So minus 2 to 0 you get a value j by 2 pi, and from 0 to 2 this minus sign is, so minus j by 2 pi minus j by 2 pi, it goes from 0 to 2. This is your Fourier transform of the given signal. Now next part says